Hello, this video was created by Vinay Bellare, a senior information developer at BMC Software, and narrated by a computer-generated voice. In this video, you will learn the options available for resynchronizing a Cmdb connection in BMC Discovery and how to resume an interrupted sync. The Cmdb resynchronization feature in BMC Discovery provides two resynchronization types: complete or one-step resynchronization. Here, if you're confident about your resynchronization, you can select a single-step process, which will complete without further intervention. It may take a long time for the commit phase to run to completion. Incremental resynchronization. Instead of waiting for a complete resynchronization commit, you can get back to normal synchronization activity immediately by performing resynchronization incrementally in the background. If a Cmdb resynchronization is interrupted for any reason, you can now resume processing where it left off. We'll go to the BMC Discovery UI. Click the administration icon, and in the model section, click Cmdb Sync. Presently, there are no connections configured, so you must add one. To do so, let's click Add Cmdb Connection. Let's enter a unique name for the connection, such as Cmdb Main. Select the connection type to connect to Cmdb. You can select any one of the following: Remedy Cmdb using REST API, Remedy Cmdb using the legacy API, Remedy Force, provided its version is 20.19.02 or later, or ServiceNow. You'll see this option only if you are licensed for it and have enabled sync for ServiceNow Cmdb. And lastly, the no export connection, where the actual data is not exported but is used only for testing. In this case, we'll select Remedy Cmdb using REST API. Enter the URL for the connection, username and password, and select continuous sync. For the dataset ID, we'll enter bmc.addm. We'll click Test Connection to verify that a connection can be established with the URL. This may take a few moments. After the test succeeds, click Add to add the Cmdb connection. You can see that Cmdb has reported that the dataset we choose is not empty. If you open the connection page and look at the Resync tab, you can see that the reason for the resync is given again. Click the Details button to open an information panel that describes the phases of a resync and the types of resync you can perform. You have three choices: complete resync, where the preparation and commit phases run consecutively; incremental resync, where the preparation and commit phases run consecutively, but the commit phase is incremental; and prepare only, where only the preparation phase occurs. It enables you to examine the changes that will be made in Cmdb if you decide to commit. You can skip complete resync and prepare only, as they are not the purpose of this video. Select incremental resync and then click Start Resync. We'll pause the recording as this can take a little while. Now you can see that the resync is progressing and the local shadow copy is being constructed. As you want to learn how to resume an interrupted resync, let us intentionally cancel or interrupt this resync. To do this, click Cancel Resync. You can see the number of nodes that have already been processed. The resync has stopped, and you have the option to either resume the incomplete resync or to start a new one. Click Resume Incomplete Resync. You can see the resumed resync is continuing. A short while later, the resync completes. Now that the resync is complete, resume continuous sync by selecting that option from the actions list. You see that the connection is shown as green and reported to be OK. In this video, you've seen the options available for resyncing a CMDB sync connection and how to resume an interrupted resync. For more information on this topic, see the BMC online documentation portal. Thanks for watching.